Man, that was scary.
In the year 1445, 24967, there was a wave, two oceans long, 15 men wide. It was the blade that sliced what we knew of humanity into shreds. Grapefruits grew all over the planet. They flowered in abundance. There was 15 million in each acre. At the end of the century, 84XY7, all of the grapefruits were rotting, and the insects grew drunk, and the whole time the salmon never paid the rent. And I have the papers to prove it.
The happiest robot.
Once upon a time, not too far away, the happiest robot got out of its little robot bed, put on its little robot shoes, clicked its happy little robot claws together, and went out into his little robot world. Little did he know the adventures he would have. The happiest robot went walking through the robot forest and it saw a little robot Robin. "How are you, robot Robin?" asked the happiest robot. "Scratch, P-C-C-C-P-C-C-R," said the Robin. The happiest robot knew that something was wrong, because robot Robins were meant to chirp in a pleasing fashion. The happiest robot ripped open the voice modulator and attempted to realign the circuitry to the stimulation mainframe, but the wires had all melted together. "That's hilarious," said the happiest robot. The happiest robot was walking along Robot Lane and he went to the robot grocery store to get a bus of robot metal shavings rolling tobacco. He rolled one up and sat down next to the robot dumpster to smoke. After he was done, he flicked the robot butt onto the ground and walked away. The happiest robot looked back a few moments later and saw the building it was sitting next to had caught on fire. "Awesome," said the happiest robot. "Hopefully all the mother robots burn to death. There has to be some kind of survival advantage in that." The happiest robot felt sleepy, but didn't have any money to pay for a hotel. "Look," said the happiest robot to itself, staring up at the condos towering above him. There are rooms with beds all over the city, and the happiest robot smashed through a window. Inside, another robot was lying on the bed. "Move," said the happiest robot. "I need to lie down." "Well, why don't you lie down with me?" said the robot slut. "Fine, but don't touch me." Despite what the happiest robot told the robot slut, it immediately started finger bam bang, jang, jang, tingling gee bam banging it. As soon as he was done with her, he left. But the happiest robot, before he went home, stole all of the robot money out of the robot slut's robot purse. The happiest robot was hungry. It decided to order a robot pizza. The happiest robot spent all of its robot money in robot toys and a robot magazine filled with pictures of raw copper wiring. But it figured it would work out. It always does for the happiest robot. the robot pizza delivery unit arrived. It demanded compensation from the happiest robot, so the happiest robot killed it with a robot baseball bat. The happiest robot blasted the delivery unit, tanked its lifeless shell, and beat it to a wiry pulp. Then the happiest robot sat in its robot rocking chair and smoked its robot pipe. Robot pipe. It's been a good day, he thought to himself. The happiest robot was tired, so he took off his little robot shoes, clicked his little robot claws together, and got into his little robot bed. The end. Die. No. Die. No. No, no, no. Six successful mass explanation.
Y'all talking about, the happiest robot this, the happiest robot that. Man, get a life.